Would you please stand to greet the arrival of the bride? Afternoon. A very warm welcome to the Church of St Michael and All Angels here in Stokenham. And the weather is set fair today, and it's been a long journey of a few postponements and hiccups for James and Kirstie, but they're here, which is the main thing, and it's great to see them. And this is the only wedding I've done for about 3 weeks when I haven't had a hammering by the springboks to look forward to afterwards. So that's good news, a blessing in itself. But a sense of belonging makes everything new and inspires us in our life. And James and Kirstie belong to each other. They found each other, and they now come to make their vows to each other. To know that they belong to each other, and that sense of belonging and those vows are lifelong and makes more of the two of them, the two halves making more of the sense of the whole. So they come too to receive the blessing of the church, and we're delighted to welcome them and you here this afternoon for that. So could I just ask a couple of things of housekeeping, and that is that James and Kirstie have asked that there shouldn't be any phone photographs during the service, please. And if you're going to throw confetti, could you please wait until you get to the bottom of the steps under the arch before you do that? This church is a fantastic building and a beautiful place in which to have a wedding And generations have done that for over 800 years, have come to the spot where James and Kirstie are now. And they stand in a long tradition of family and also members of this community in doing that, which is marvellous. But it does cost us about £1,000 a week to keep up. So if anybody feels moved to give a donation to us, there's an opportunity to do that at the back of the church. Thank you. So let's now begin our wedding celebration. And we're going to do that by listening to the hymn, Lord of the Dance. So congregation, would you please sit down while we listen to that hymn? Come here to take James and Kirstie into our hearts today and to pour out our love on them. I'm now going to say a prayer that expresses some of that love. God our Father, from the beginning you have blessed creation with abundant life. Pour out your blessings now upon James and Kirstie, that they may be joined in mutual love and companionship, in holiness and commitment to each other. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. If I could invite the bridal party apart from James and Kirstie to sit and invite Uncle Tom to come and give us the reading, please.
Mm. A reading from St. Paul's first letter to the Corinthians. If I speak in the tongues of mortals and of angels, but do not have love, I am a noisy gong or a clanging cymbal. And if I have prophetic powers and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have all faith, so as to remove mountains, but do not have love, I am nothing. If I give away all my possessions, and if I hand over my body so that I may boast, but do not have love, I gain nothing. Love is patient. Love is kind. Love is not envious or boastful or arrogant or rude. It does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice in wrongdoing, but rejoices in the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends. And now, faith, hope, and love abide. These three, and the greatest of these is love, the word of the Lord.
Thank you, Tom. We've come together in the presence of God to witness the marriage of James and Kirstie and to ask his blessing on them and to share in their joy. Our Lord Jesus Christ was himself a guest at a wedding at Cana of Galilee, and through his Spirit he is with us now. The scriptures teach us that marriage is a gift of God in creation and a means of his grace, a holy mystery in which man and woman become one flesh. It is God's purpose that as husband and wife give themselves to each other in love throughout their lives, they shall be united in that love as Christ is united with his church. Marriage is given that husband and wife may comfort and help each other, living faithfully together in need and in plenty, in sorrow and in joy. It is given that with delight and tenderness they may know each other in love, and through the joy of their bodily union may strengthen the union of their hearts and lives. It is given as the foundation of family life, in which children may be born and nurtured in accordance with God's will and to his praise and glory. In marriage, husband and wife belong to one another, and they begin a new life together in the community. It is a way of life that all should honour, and it must not be taken carelessly, lightly, or selfishly, but reverently, responsibly, and after serious thought. This is the way of life created and hallowed by God that James and Kirstie are to begin now. They will each give their consent to the other, they will join hands and exchange solemn vows, and in token of this, they will each give and receive a ring. Therefore, on this their wedding day, we pray with them that, strengthened and guided by God, they may fulfill this purpose for the whole of their earthly life together. But first, I'm required to ask anyone present who knows a reason why these persons may not lawfully marry to declare it now. Moving swiftly on to you two, the vows you are about to take are to be made in the presence of God, who is judge of all and knows the secrets of our hearts. Therefore, if either of you knows a reason why you may not lawfully marry, you must declare it now. Good, let's stand up and get married then. So if I can have bride and groom back to the middle, and bridesmaids and best man, please. James, will you take Kirstie to be your wife? Will you love her, comfort her, honour and protect her, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live?
I will.
Kirstie, will you take James to be your husband? Will you love him, comfort him, honour and protect him, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live?
I will.
Question for everyone present as well, please, to which the answer is, we will. Will you, the family and friends of James and Kirstie, support and uphold them in their marriage now and in the years to come? We will. Could I ask the congregation to please stand for the vows? So James, if you take Kirstie's right hand in your right hand and say after me. I, James, take you, Kirstie.
I, James, take you, Kirstie.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death us do part.
Till death us do part.
According to God's holy law.
According to God's holy law.
In the presence of God.
In the presence of God.
I make this vow.
I make this vow.
And if you loose hands and cast. Take James's right hand in your right hand and say after me, I, Kirstie, take you, James.
I, Kirstie, take you, James.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
Till death us do part.
Till death do us part. According to God's holy law.
According to God's holy law.
In the presence of God.
In the presence of God.
I make this vow.
I make this vow.
You can loose hands and face the front, please. Heavenly Father, by your blessing, let these rings be to James and Kirstie a symbol of unending love and faithfulness, to remind them of the vow and covenant which they have made this day through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. James, would you like to get Kirstie's ring, please? And then if you face it, James, if you face each other, pop it on the fourth finger of her left hand. Oh dear. Are we right?
Yeah.
Good, okay, and just hold it there and say after me. Kirstie, I give you this ring.
Kirstie, I give you this ring.
As a sign of our marriage.
As a sign of our marriage.
With my body, I honour you.
With my body, I honour you.
All that I am, I give to you.
All that I am, I give to you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
All that I have, I share with you.
Within the love of God.
Within the love of God.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Sons and James, if you get your ring now and give it to Kirstie. So you hold it there and then say after me. James, I give you this ring. As a sign of our marriage.
As a sign of our marriage.
With my body, I honour you.
With my body, I honour you.
All that I am, I give to you.
All that I am, I give to you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
All that I have, I share with you.
Within the love of God.
Within the love of God.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
In the presence of God and before this congregation, James and Kirstie have given their consent and made their marriage vows to each other. They have declared their marriage by the joining of hands and by the giving and receiving of rings. I therefore proclaim that they are husband and wife. Those whom God has joined together, let no one put asunder. And I think we can give them a round of applause. Good. We're now going to listen to the hymn, Give Me Joy in My Heart. I'm going to ask James and Kirstie to kneel now as I give them, in the name of the church, the ancient blessing for married couples. Blessed are you, O Lord our God, for you have created joy and gladness, pleasure and delight, love, peace and fellowship. Pour out the abundance of your blessing upon James and Kirstie in their new life together. Let their love for each other be a seal upon their hearts and a crown upon their heads. Bless them in their work and in their companionship, awake and asleep, in joy and in sorrow, in life and in death. Finally, in your mercy, bring them to that banquet where your saints feast forever in your heavenly home. We ask this through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit, bless, preserve, and keep you. The Lord mercifully grant you the riches of his grace, that you may please him both in body and soul, and living together in faith and love, may receive the blessings of eternal life. Amen. Please stand. We're now going to make our prayer for James and Kirstie. And when I say the words, Lord of life and love, I invite you to respond, hear our prayer. Lord of life and love, hear our prayer. Faithful God, holy and eternal, source of life and spring of love, we thank and praise you for bringing James and Kirstie to this day, and we pray for them. Lord of life and love, hear our prayer. May their marriage be life-giving and lifelong, enriched by your presence and strengthened by your grace. May they bring comfort and confidence to each other in faithfulness and trust. Lord of life and love, hear our prayer. May the hospitality of their home bring refreshment and joy to all around them. May their love overflow to neighbours in need and embrace those who are in distress. Lord of life and love, hear our prayer. May they nurture their family with devotion, see their children grow in body, mind, and spirit, and come at last to the end of their lives with hearts content in joyful anticipation of heaven. Lord of life and love, hear our prayer. So let us pray together with confidence as our Saviour has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. I'm now going to invite Nanny Pam to come and give us a reading.
Love, it will not betray you, dismay or enslave you. It will set you free, be more like the man you were made to be. There is a design, an alignment, a cry of my heart to see the beauty of love as it was made to be. Thank you. Sorry, I'm so slow.
Thank you, Nanny Pam. We're going to listen to the hymn now, One More Step Along the World, I Go. And as we do that, I'm going to lead James and Kirstie to the marriage document signing. So if I could ask those who are witnessing the document to come over to the table as well during the hymn, please. One more step along the world.
Thank you.
And as we sign the register, we're going to listen to the hymn, Morning Has Broken. Tread on the train. You ready then? Okay, congratulations. Have a fantastic good day. Okay. Good. Would you like to stand to greet Mr. and Mrs. Trout as they leave the church?
Always be my only guiding light. To believe in, and you know I'm going.